Yo, what's good, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Fusi Max back at it with another one. I missed you guys, and listen, I know I haven't been uploading as much as I used to, but you know, all of that is about to change now. I'm back. I've been playing a little too hard. You can't blame me. It's been a good 2-3 months of training. So, at the same time, you gotta know when's the right time to kind of like relax when you reach your targets and then play for a little bit and then go back with a refreshed mind. So, that's what I've been doing. I've been recharging. I've been like trading a lot less, but we've been like winning still. You saw what the Nets 100 did the other week, but I'm still gonna cover it on this video, right? So just stay tuned, subscribe to the channel if you already haven't subscribed, man. I appreciate y'all. The channel is growing and stuff, so I got an analysis for you in this morning, right? I have the USD JPY, I got the NZD USD, I got the USD saw, right, and the Nets 100. So just sit tight, check out the analysis, and remember I got a free WhatsApp group that you should join if you already haven't joined it. And in the group, basically that's where I send all the setups and stuff like that and some trade alerts. It's a totally free group, whatever, right? So just go check it out. And before we take too much time, we need to focus on what's important, so let's start with the analysis. All right, so the first chart that we're going to start with today is the USD ZAR, right? So with the USD ZAR, I want you to look at the daily time frame. When you look at the daily time frame, you will see that I have this main trend line there that's marked by green, right? Also, I have the reversal trend line, which is marked in blue. Yeah, so with the reversal trend line, you can see we had a breakout there, and then we moved to a new low. That's what we're going to call this level. We moved to a new low, then we kind of retraced back and tested this level, right? So I want to show you how we came about to draw this trend line first, right? So you're going to go to the H4 time frame. So in the H4 time frame, what you're going to do is you're going to look at what happened ever since. You're going to start with the high that's on the 5th of April, right? So you're gonna like start drawing your main trend line from there. You're gonna connect it with the second high, which is a lower high, which happened at the 23-24 April, right? So you're gonna go there, and you're gonna draw a trend line, then you're gonna align it to the price, current price, where the price is at right now, right? And if you go to where the price is at, you can see we're kind of still far from the trend line, but I think we might still see like the price go and test that level. So for that reason, we need to have the trend line in place in the case that the market or the price of this pair goes and then like makes contact with the trend line. We need to know what's gonna happen, so the trend line is gonna be there to give us that assurance that even if the price doesn't continue going down, if it goes up, then we can like use the trend line as a signal to either buy or sell into strength, right? So now we're gonna go back to the daily, right? No, we're not gonna go back to the daily. What we're gonna do is we're gonna look at how I drew the reversal line now, right? So the reversal line, what you're gonna do is you're gonna join these two lows right there. This low, which was on the 31st of March, and then this wick, the end of this candlestick wick, which was on the 9th of April, right? So what you're gonna see with this pair is the highs here were getting lower and the lows were getting higher, so the price was like moving sideways. So when the price is moving like this and you isolate it between two trend lines like this, eventually it's gonna run out of space, and the market has to pick a side. Is it it's gonna go with the buyers or go with the sellers, right? It's never guaranteed that it's gonna go with the buyers or sellers. You just gotta wait for a breakout and enter upon that breakout, right? So there was a trade there, because then the market broke to the push to the downside, so there was a huge sell-off of this pair there, right? So now what happened is, let's go to the daily now. So what happened is, the market, we had this huge selling off there after we broke out of this reversal line with a huge selling off there. And what actually happened now is the market went to test a level, which I'm gonna highlight. It's also this low, and it's like this area there also, because there was a resistance and a support there. So I'm just gonna draw the line and show you what I'm talking about. So this is the level that I'm telling you guys about. We had a support there, and at the price, when we broke out of that, when we broke out of the reversal line, we had a selling off. We bounced, we kind of tested the level, and then we broke through it, and then now we came and tested it, right? So what's happening with this pair now is, either one of two things can either happen, right? It's either we're gonna continue selling off, right? But these two candlesticks that I'm focusing on suggested like we don't have enough momentum to kind of keep going as we did there. So you can expect this pair to kind of go back up. Either we're gonna retest this zone again, and then we're gonna sell as we reject to go above this level, or if we go above it, then we can buy and expect to close the trades somewhere there, because we might see a retest and then the price might go back down. But overall, I think the price of this is in a downtrend, because you can see that we have our downtrend line. So now it's just a matter of where do we enter. So you gotta join the WhatsApp group. The link is gonna be the first pinned comment in the comment section. Just go join, so you can be there when I let the group know that like now's the time to sell this pair, or now's the time to buy this pair, or whatever. All right, so that's all we got for USDs. Let's go to the next pair. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna look at the USD JPY on a monthly time frame, right? And obviously this pair, we've analyzed it like a long time ago. I think it's a couple of weeks now, if it's not close to a month, right? So already we can see what's going on here. We have like basically what was happening in the previous pair is the same thing that's kind of happening here, where we have the highs getting lower, and we have the lows getting higher. So the pair, like I'm saying, excuse me, the pair, like I'm saying, we're running out of space to like have any more price action, you understand? So because of that, now we have to like, it's either there's gonna be a breakout to the upside or a breakout to the downside. But because it's a monthly time frame, what it means is that you're gonna have to wait for a monthly close, right? So to avoid this false break to the upside and this false break to the downside, you need to wait for the monthly close. Because if you don't wait for the monthly close, you're just gonna keep getting faked out like it's been doing for the past 6 months or so, right? So eventually we're gonna have a breakout, and then that obviously, because we're on a monthly time frame, like the movement that's gonna happen there is gonna last for a long time. We're talking like a potential of like upwards of 3 months in a rally or in a bear market, you understand? So you need to prepare for this one, get your funds ready and stuff like that, because whenever this market breaks out, it's gonna be wild. You see, you feel what I'm saying? So I just need you to keep having this one on. So I might still remind you next week or whatever, to like, or at the end of the month. I think I might just remind you guys at the end of the month to still have this one, because whenever we get that candlestick close on a monthly time frame, then that's going to be when everything takes off, right? So let's go to the next pair. All right, guys, so what we're going to look at now, we're going to look at the New Zealand dollar against the US dollar on the weekly time frame. Then you can see that we have this major trend line, this main trend line that we have here. So the price right now, where it's at, we're moving closer to the trend line, closing closer to the trend line, and it's at a point where we can either see a rejection, or we'll either see a breakout out of this trend line. And but me, I'm looking forward to like a rejection of this trend line, right? So let's go to the daily time frame, and I'm gonna go into detail about what's happening. So now looking at the daily time frame, right, we can see this pair. It's basically, like I said last week, I said we're gonna wait for it, for the price to either make contact with the main trend line or make contact with the red trend line, right? And the thing now is, if we if we make contact here and we reject, then we have to sell, right? Then when we sell in, that means we're hoping for the price to get back to this level and even push further below this level and break out of here and continue the trend downwards there, just right, just like it's been happening here. We had a rejection here and then the price like started selling off for like the next month or so. So that's the thing. So we're expecting the same thing to happen here. Like, we're expecting to see the price reject and then start making new lows, right? Because like, you with price action, you see that the market tends to repeat the same cycles over and over again. So it's all about recognizing those patterns and entering at the right time. So just like on the other pair, I will definitely let you guys know when that rejection happens, right? So let's go to the last pair that I want to talk about. So now we're going to look at the NES 100, right? So this was a very short trade compared to like the other week when we opened this, and then I think we held it for like a whole week or something. But then now I told you guys that the same thing that happened here was going to happen here, right? So this one paid off nicely, and I just want to congratulate everybody who was able to catch some nice pips and dollar signs off of this one. But I'm gonna talk about this one. I'm gonna be dropping another video today, so I'm gonna talk more about what happened here, right? So you gotta stay tuned for that, because you know what I'm saying, I'm not trying to really keep this video to be too long and stuff, but I have an important message that I want to talk to you guys about on the next one. All right, so we're done with the analysis now.
If you watched the video, I told us for thank you so much for watching. You understand what I'm saying? Subscribe, like I said, but at this point you should have already subscribed, my G. So subscribe, like the video, comment, let me know what you think, just give me feedback, go join the free WhatsApp group and stuff. So thank you guys for watching. I will definitely see you guys later. Strictly business.